last 2 weeks, I've had you been getting back to basics, and a lot of that is face flexing, two tracking, leg laterals, all of those things. So we'll, so hopefully you've done the big X's with the two tracking, where you can get nose one direction, shoulder the other, and draw a giant X. The other was transitions, post-trot, face flex left and right, and sit jog, breaking the pole vertically. So now we're going to apply that to a single barrel. And you can do that on first, second, and third on your pattern, but for video purposes, I'm only going to work on third barrel right now. So I'll show it to you how to walk, and a trot, and a loop. So first, contact on both reins, so both legs, both reins, and sitting on your pocket. We'll work on a nice circle. And I'm just going to sit jog. The point of this exercise is collection. So we want collection. So I'm going to have a little weight on my outside stirrup. I'm going to have a little contact on both reins. When I go in for my circle, quarter turn ahead. I want shoulder out, ribs out, hips in, so we get in the noticeable face straight. Same thing when I post trot here. I can put her head vertically, but I'm going to just stay in a sit jog for right now because I want a little bit over collected. So again, you need to be able to get your horse to tuck their nose even with their eyes. Again, I have a little weight. Really hard on your legs because you gotta squeeze the whole time. It's a good workout. Really gonna go ahead and roll. Roll. And go the other way. Okay, so I'm gonna put her up in the bridle. Remember, this for people that are having trouble with their horses using their hindquarters or swinging their butt, it's because you're getting too much space laterally. And you're cranking your nose in like this, when you don't want to do that, you want their face where you barely see eyelashes to the inside, you know, just eyelashes to the inside, and shoulders out from your inside leg, hips out from your inside leg, and that'll automatically put your hips in. So I'm going to release her and get her in a jog, and once I get in the speed I want, you always got to give the release to get the speed. And then I'm going to go ahead and ask her to bridle up again. And then you'll repeat this transition from loping the big one to transitioning down and jogging the small one. And I'll try to demonstrate.